Congo's December presidential elections, Martin Fayulu has called for peaceful protest. The protest come as a constitutional court upheld the victory of opposition candidate Felix Tshisekedi. Fayulu earlier argued that Tshisekedi had made a power-sharing deal with outgoing president Joseph Kabila. Tshisekedi's team denies this. He's due to be sworn in within the next 10 days. Despite the court ruling, Fayulu says he is the legitimate president. He's urged the international community not to recognize the official election result. As the Congolese wait with bated breath for the final presidential results in that country to be announced, M17 Vice President Kuku Itambo has called for a political solution to the current political situation in the country. In an exclusive interview with the SABC's foreign editor, Sophie Mukwena, Itambo says they support the African Union's position that the Electoral Commission should not announce the final results. She's warned that the DRC could slide into a civil war if a political solution is not found.
If they let us go forward with the actual situation, something bad will happen. People are not ready to accept those kind of results because it's not real. Okay, we want real results. But us as M17, we believe that we need to go for a political solution because it won't work anyway. If they ask us today to recount the vote, it won't work because they didn't put everything together after election. So how are they going to recount? Based on what? This is the first difficulty we have. So for us, it will be better to put all leaders, Congolese leaders together, and to have some African leader to help us to mediate, so that we can reach to a political solution.
For more on this story, we have on the line Leonard Mulunda. He's the spokesperson for the Union for Democracy and Social Progress in South Africa. A very good morning to you. What are your reactions to the Concord ruling in the DRC?
Good morning to you and a good morning to all the viewers and listeners of SABC, and thank you for having me. Our first reaction, we welcome the Concord, the ruling by the Congolese Constitutional Court, which confirmed the victory of His Excellency Felix Antoine Tshisekedi Chilombo as the fifth DRC president. And let me put it on record. There is no political crisis. There is no institutional crisis. There is a Martin Fayulu who has been put forward by multinational companies that they are used to loot Congolese resources for over centuries. Now, when they witness that the new president that is going to take over from Joseph Kabila is Felix Tshisekedi, they are all scared because they understand the policy of Felix Tshisekedi. It's centered by the people. So his policy is people first. So we dismiss those allegations suggesting that there is a political crisis. There is none, but we welcome the Concord ruling, which confirmed the victory of Felix Tshisekedi, and we call upon all Congolese in Congo and the diaspora to rally behind the new president so that they can help him to fulfill his vision.
It's not only Fayulu who is questioning the results. Just before we spoke to you, we had our foreign editor spoke to the president of M17, the vice president, Kuku Itambo, who was also saying that we need a different solution. But also the African Union, SADC, and the United Nations have said that there needs to be further conversation about this result.
Firstly, there was no decision of the African Union. There was a troika. We need to distinguish between the head of state meeting under African Union and the double troika, where there was a few head of state and the members of the SADC communities. But look, firstly, the decision by the troika to say the final result were not supposed to be announced, to us, it was a joke to the Congolese people. You cannot give a political view to stop the work of the Constitutional Court. So you are having a political view and you are telling the Constitutional Court that do not fulfill your constitutional mandate because this is a view we have. understand why these African leaders do not want to agree that Félix Tshisekedi is the real winner, because we know Moïse Katumbi travel and meet some of head of state and try to lobby them, but we understand that Fayulu is just a front door. Behind him, we understand, is a war of Congolese people and the multinationals. So we don't really care for the African Union to come and dictate. You know, there is a principle of non-interference. They cannot interfere with the Congolese internal matters that were before court, and to tell the court that stop and until we speak and you can do your work. So for us, it was a joke, and we reject that, and we want the will of Congolese people to be respected.
Is it important for you that Mr. Tshisekedi's presidency is above board and credible?
It is credible. Who define credibility? It's a Congolese people. In South Africa, in May, you are going to have election. So I don't think South African will say, let us wait for President Kagame to come and tell us who win. It is defined by the people of South Africa to elect their leader. Why for Congo it has to be something else? So only people of country of that country can define the credibility, not President Paul Kagame, not SADC, not African Union. So for us, the decision that was handed down by that troika, it's a joke and it's a mockery to the Congolese people. Remember, Congolese people have been suffering a lot. This is not the first election. In 2006, when there was a dispute between Jean-Pierre Bemba and Joseph Kabila, where were the AU and this troika? In 2011, when our former leader, Etienne Tshisekedi, you know, when he complained about the result, where were the African Union? But we understand why they are coming now. It's because they want to fulfill the will of the multinationals. Remember, Congo is a rich country. But when you go to see the life of people, they are very poor. Why? Because multinationals were taking our minerals, they were looting, they were imposing our leaders. So for now, Congolese people have taken a decision to say, stop. Now we are taking charge of our own country, and that's why you see people are crying food. So we don't really care. We want the AU to work with Congo by respecting the will of people, because no country can allow outsiders to come and tell them why who must become a leader and who must not become a leader. So Congolese people must be respected.
So Mr. Fayulu now wants to embark on in protest action. What are the chances of success, and what? How can we define the success? Because as it seems now, it doesn't look like the decision will be overturned.
The Concord final, the decision by the Concord is final. Let me remind you, who knew Fayulu 10 years ago? UDPS is a party which was formed on 15 of February 1982. That party was formed under the sacrifice of people. Congolese people were very alive because of the UDPS. So Martin Fayulu doesn't have numbers. And let me remind you, 2 days before the election, Martin Fayulu did call for people to stay away. Nothing happened. He's calling for protest. Watch the street of Congo. You will see there will be nobody going to protest. If there will be few people, they are not going to be more than 100. He understands very well that between him and Félix Tshisekedi, Martin Fayulu was not going to beat Félix Tshisekedi by any chance. He knows that. But it's a guy who has been put forward by multinational. He took money. They signed some contract in Belgium, in Geneva. So now he need to be to account for the money that he spent during the campaign. So we understand that. We understand that the Congolese people are at war with multinational. So Martin Fayulu, if he really loves Congo, he must accept the invitation by His Excellency Félix Tshisekedi. He extends his hand to everyone who wants to work in the best interest of Congolese people. So if Fayulu is going to reject that, he's going to be considered as the enemy number one of Congolese people.
Félix Tshisekedi steps into into the hem of a presidency that's in a country that's very volatile right now. What leadership qualities does he possess that will bring about calm and quell the tensions in the DRC?
Remember, when we talk about the leadership quality, we can see in all the candidates that were there, You know, even if you could take Martin Fayulu and Félix Tshisekedi, in Congo, Félix Tshisekedi has been called like a white hands. You know, he's innocent because he never even steal any money from government. The leadership quality is going to put forward is first priority is to make sure that the eastern part of the DRC is going to get its peace, because we know those wars were created by multinationals so that they can have an opportunity to loot the resources. Secondly, the issue of corruption has let the Congolese people down. So the Tshisekedi has spoken strongly about how to fight corruption. He's going to put measures in place to fight corruption, because corruption is not going to help the Congo to be developed. And the other one, it's going to make sure that the government and the state, there are going to be a difference between the three arm of states. So democracy and the voice, freedom of speech from Congolese is going to be restored again. So the leadership qualities that we are expecting from our leader is that corruption is going to say goodbye. And the war and all this conflict in the eastern part that has been set up by multinationals in collusion with other European countries are going to end. So those are quality leadership that we want. It's a leadership that puts people first, and he put himself behind the people.
You say that he's a brand new leader and that's an advantage for the DRC, but some people say that inexperience will prove to be a difficulty for him, especially in terms of dealing with the long-standing wars that you're talking about in the east of the DRC and the fights between the rebels. How will he be able to reach out to all these different warring groups?
Those critics, check them well, you will see they're outsiders. They are people who knows nothing about the DRC. So ask that question to Congolese people. They're going to give you an answer. So we don't care about what outsiders and the European media are saying, because they've been saying this before election. They've been saying during the campaign. They've been even saying now, so that, you know, they can have an opportunity to, you know, to damage the reputation of our leader. We don't really care. We believe in our leader. We know the quality that he has. He has got the special qualities, and the Congolese people knows why they went to choose him. So we don't really care about those critics. Those are outsiders. They are very upset because they lost billions. They see like looting is not going to take place no more. So we don't really care. Ask this question to Congolese people, they're going to tell you. Félix Tshisekedi, it's a leader who possesses qualities. It is on the basis of these qualities that Congolese people went to elect him. So he's going to do a great job, and the Congolese people are going to be respected from now in Congo and outside. Remember, for the past few years, Congolese people have been, you know, have been seen like a joke. When you travel as a Congolese, you go to any airport around the world, they check your passport when you are Congolese. You look like you are suspicious. Why? Because our country was destroyed. But now we have a leader who's going to to restore our confidence and our value as a giant country in Africa, as a giant country in the world in terms of minerals. So we know our leader possesses the qualities, and we don't care about the critics that are from outsiders. They can go jump, but our leader is there and is going to stay there for the next 5 years.
Mr. Malunda, the new president is expected to be sworn in the next 10 days. What happens in the interim?
For now, there is a very good preparation for the peaceful ending of power. Remember, we've been having four presidents. The Félix Tshisekedi is the fifth one. We had the Joseph Kasavubu, we had the Joseph Mobutu, we had the Laurent Kabila, we had now Joseph Kabila. We never witnessed a peaceful transition of power. So there is a lot of work, you know. The president has set up his office at the Beatrice Hotel, where he has got a very quality team that is working on the peaceful transition of power. But in the next or 2 days, we are going to tell the public about what is going to unfold. But for now, our focus is on how do we make sure that we transfer power from the outgoing president, which I congratulate, Joseph Kabila, and the incoming president, who's His Excellency Félix Tshisekedi.
You see, this is one of the things that analysts grapple to get, put around their heads. Your profuse congratulations for the outgoing president when it hasn't always been the case. Tell us why, what brought about this turnabout.
Look, I understand. When you read the UN, United Nations Charter, the mission of the UN is to make sure that peace and the stability is restored. And let me take you back. I'm living in South Africa, the country of Nelson Mandela. When Nelson Mandela was released from jail, what did he do? He organized a dinner with people who sent him to jail. Why that was not criticized? And if, you know, congratulating Kabila is going to help, to help us to build peace and the stability, why can't we do that? Because it is in line with the mission of the UN. So if you see leaders around the world, they are trying to criticize the move which is going to help Congolese people with the reconciliation, then you need to understand that there is something that they are missing. For us, we congratulate Joseph Kabila because when you check in the greater region, Congo is the first country. So we are setting up a model which other countries are going to emulate, to say, don't go to war to take power. Go to people, seek power, and use legal means to go to power. So this is a new model that we are going to set up. We don't really care about the people that are criticizing. But for us, we have to thank Kabila because he's been in power for almost 18 years. It was not easy, but for him to accept to step down without any war or any chaos is something that we need to consider, because our main focus is to reconcile all Congolese people. See, this is something that Nelson Mandela did, to pave the way for peace and the stability. So if we do that and the people are criticizing, remember that they are missing something, which is our minerals.
Indeed, the fact that the outgoing president has agreed to step down without contesting the results is being seen as a big breakthrough. But tell us, did the leader of the Union for Democracy and Social Progress strike a deal with Joseph Kabila?
There is no deal. People who are talking about that, they're outsiders. But remember, Martin Fayulu is talking about the deal between our leader, who is the president of DRC, and Joseph Kabila. But why did he run to President Paul Kagame? What democratic lessons Paul Kagame has, he can lecture in DRC. When we talk about war, there is involvement of Rwanda. So if you have Martin Fayulu, who's accusing Felix Tshisekedi that he made a deal with Joseph Kabila, but the same Martin Fayulu is running to President Paul Kagame to say, come here and come lecture us about the democracy. So it's a joke. So people who are criticizing that, they are waiting for multinationals. They knew that there is no argument. They cannot provide evidence. So if there is a deal, ask Martin Fayulu to put that deal on public. There is no deal between UDPS and outgoing president. But as someone who is in power, who has been in power for 17 years, accepting not to stand again for election after all this pressure, and also accepting the outcome of the result, it's something that the international community, AU and SADC, should congratulate. Don't listen to Martin Fayulu.
Mr. Malunda, we have to wrap up the conversation, but we hope you come in one of these days into studio in the lead up to the inauguration. But just a quick one. Why does the Union for Democracy and Social Progress have presence in South Africa? What brought about that need?
Remember, the Union for Democracy and Social Progress was formed on 15th of February, 1982, under the regime of Mobutu. And that was the time Mobutu didn't allow any party to exist. So that created a lot of people to leave the country, to go to Europe, in Africa, and all over the world. So because our party was standing for the Congolese people, we establish ourselves working with our office in Kinshasa so that we can work with institutions of countries that are hostiles like South Africa, and to try and speak about the issue of Congo. So that is the reason why you see UDPS is represented all over around the world.
Thank you so much for your time.
Okay, thank you for having me.
Mr. Leonard Malunda is a spokesperson for the Union for Democracy and Social Progress in South Africa.